What happens when Facebook forces businesses to quit accepting your credit card and your debit card? Facebook is already too big, Facebook is already too powerful, and it's used that power in far too many cases to exploit people's privacy. That's just unacceptable. Now Facebook wants us to trust them to finance and issue their own currency through a Swiss bank account. We cannot let that happen. We know some businesses have already gone cashless. What happens when Facebook forces businesses to quit accepting your credit card and your debit card? You could be forced to use Facebook's new monopoly money. What about small business owners forced to use it or lose access to Facebook's billions of users? Not only will they have to pay whatever fees Facebook tells them to pay, whatever fees Facebook demands, but Facebook could collect data about who mom and pop shops' biggest customers are and sell it to their big box competitors. For hundreds of years, we have had strong laws to prevent banks from teaming up with other companies to take control of markets and jack up prices on consumers or squeeze competitors out. This is a recipe for more corporate power over markets and over consumers and fewer protections for ordinary people. Silicon Valley likes to move fast. They like to break things. But that doesn't work when you're talking about people's jobs and you're talking about their retirement savings. Mark Zuckerberg has said that Facebook is more like a government than a company. That's delusional. That's how powerful these guys think they really are. We have to protect our democracy. We should be making it harder, not easier, to concentrate so much power in big corporations like big banks and big tech companies like Google and Facebook. It's why I'm demanding Facebook come before Congress and explain itself.